Okay, in this video, we will be opening and playing with a replica of a 1950s diving sub toy. According to the package, it's the original 1950s cereal premium. It surfaces and dives over and over, powered by household baking powder. On the back of the package, there's some instructions, and on the front, it shows a neat illustration of a 1950s submarine. Now, opening this, I was surprised to read on the package that it's actually made in the United States, unlike anything else plastic these days. It does seem like it's of high quality construction, although it's plastic and it's hollow by nature of its design, so don't expect more than that. But it works well, and it doesn't feel too cheap. Definitely worth the $3.95 that it cost in the magic shop I bought it in the mall. So there it is. It's pretty hollowed out, but it has to be. Works well though. And the conning tower piece removes, and inside is the bubble chamber and screen grid assembly, which we'll see a little later on. Alright, you'll need a bowl. It says that you need about 6 or 7 inches of water. This one is about 5. It's all I had on hand, but it worked fine. Fill it with clear water. The clearer the better. It will enable you to see it better. On the back are the instructions. The first step is to fill the container with 6 or 7 inches of water. Then you need to pull out the periscope radar assembly on top of the sub. Dip the sub in the water, then shake out the excess water, leaving moisture only in the screen grid area. What that does is a little piece of screen inside allows the water to form a barrier, keeping the powder from falling through. So that's a very important part. Again, use baking powder, not baking soda. There is a difference, although this can cost about $1 at the store. So no big deal. Use a little spoon or knife and you can scoop it out. One thing that I learned was that it's better to put it in loosely and don't fill it all the way to the top. But step 2 says fill the bubble chamber completely with loose charge of baking powder, not baking soda. Wipe off excess baking powder, which is kind of impossible because once you've dipped it in the water, it's kind of going to stick to it like glue. But put it in loosely, not too tight. And you can kind of scrape off a little bit and then put that piece back on top. Make sure that it sits firmly because it needs to be sealed. Alright, now the next step, very important, is immediately insert the periscope radar assembly, putting it back in, which we've done, and then make sure you shake it underwater very vigorously. It says grasp the sub by the conning tower and shake vigorously under the water a few times. Let go and the sub will submerge and surface automatically. Gently stir the water and the sub will cruise in circles. So the big shake was a major important part of it. And as you can see, it works. And it'll do this for several minutes. Kind of spin up the water then, and it'll cruise in circles and dive and come back up several times. Good, cheap entertainment. No wires or electronics needed. You can see it cruises around just like the real thing. Every once in a while a bubble will come out and it will dive to the bottom. You'll also notice that your water will get murkier and murkier as the powder comes out, mixes with the water. To set it over again, all you have to do is rinse it out and start over again. One can of baking powder will last you for several hours if you wanted to. And then now here's a tight shot so you can kind of see what it looks like up close. Pretty much just like the real thing. This would be really fun to have like in a bathtub or like a kid's pool or something where you had more space for it. And this awesome little toy is made by Toysmith in the United States of America.